The high impedance, or high Z mode, is used when connecting the amplifier's output to 70V or 100V high impedance speaker lines. By default, the amplifier is configured for low Z mode, commonly used for 2, 4, 8, or 16 ohm speaker loads. To activate the high Z feature, open up the amplifier's device panel by double-clicking on the virtual representation of the amplifier. Next, double-click on the mode button to open up the amplifier mode settings. In the upper right corner of this window, select either 70V or 100V to match the high Z mode with the speakers used in the audio system. The high Z voltage setting is a global setting and will tell each channel configured to high Z to be set to that specific output voltage. Now, select which individual channels you want to be high Z by selecting the radio button under the high Z header. The channel selected to high Z will be set to the global voltage setting, either 70 or 100V. The channel set to low Z will remain unchanged. In this example, only channels 3 and 4 are set to 70V. If you are not using 70 or 100V high impedance speakers, it is recommended to use the default low Z setting. When a channel is configured for high Z, you will notice that the crossover icon for that channel changes from gray to blue. This indicates there is a modification from the default settings within that processing block. When high Z is selected, the amplifier automatically implements a 35Hz high-pass filter to help prevent against saturation of the speaker's transformer. The high-pass filter frequency can be raised if desired. 70Hz is common for many applications. Notice how the store button is lit up yellow. This indicates that there has been a change that has not been stored yet. Let's click on the store button to save this preset. When the store preset window opens, select a preset that is not being used. Give it a useful name and even an identifying color. When you're finished, press OK to store the preset. You should notice that the store button turned from yellow to gray, indicating that the settings in the amplifier match the settings in the preset. Thank you for watching this video. For questions, comments, or suggestions regarding this or any other video, please send them to the email address shown below. For technical assistance, please call the technical support department or email them at the options shown below.